There are two ways to utilize the virtual digitizer. Take a photo of the pattern or garment, load the image, and then digitize the image. Use a large screen TV or a monitor as a digitizing board. If you have a real scale pattern file, like a PDF file, do not use the virtual digitizer. It would be best to open it in a software like Adobe Illustrator or any software that can export out in DXF format. Make sure your working units are set to inches, not pixels. When exporting to DXF format, scale should be 1 in inches and 1 in units as well. Then import the DXF file back into the TUKAdesign software using the DXF AI format and make sure it's in inches as well. To use the first method using a photo, it's best to set up an area where you can take photos of the pattern. If you have an empty wall, make a frame using something like masking tape. You will need to measure the frame horizontally and vertically, or make the frame to the exact area of the space you want to use. This is to help with the real scale calibration. You do not need to use a wall, you can use anything like the floor or a table. There just needs to be a frame around the pattern pieces. Within the frame, arrange your patterns or garments and set up a camera or camera phone. Use a tripod or anything to help take a good stable photo of the pattern within the frame. Photos should be as straight as possible, not too angled or skewed. Before you start digitizing, you will need to calibrate the virtual digitizer. There are three methods of calibration: by screen, image, and grainline. The default calibration is by screen. As you can see, when you resize the digitizer window, the work area size is adjusting. The work area is the black area. As mentioned earlier, you can hook up a large TV as a second monitor and move the virtual digitizer window to it. Depending on the TV and resolution, especially 4K TVs, the auto screen calibration might not be able to detect the correct dimensions. You should physically measure the actual work area horizontally and vertically and compare. If the measurements are not accurate, enter the values manually. Test the calibration by digitizing a piece of paper. Make sure the digitized paper is correct with shape and dimensions. Once the test piece is verified, remember the values for the future use. Then you can proceed with digitizing your patterns. Load the photo image of the patterns that was taken with the frame. Using the frame, we are going to calibrate the virtual digitizer. Click on the image calibration button. Following the guided direction, click on the lower left corner, then upper left corner, then upper right corner, and lastly, the lower right corner. Then enter the physical measurements of the frame taken, horizontally, X value, and vertically, Y value. Depending on how the photos are taken, distance and angle, you will need to set the image calibration every time prior to digitizing the image. A frame is not needed when using the grainline calibration. Before taking a photo, draw and measure the grainline. After digitizing the pattern, set the grainline measurement and digitize the grainline by using the grainline tool shortcut, letter B. Click on the first and last point with the left mouse click. This will proportionally scale the digitized pattern. However, it is still best to use the image calibration instead of the grainline calibration. As you can see in this photo image, it looks skewed. The system will attempt to compensate for skewness when using image calibration. Like a regular digitizer, you have buttons to create points, curve points, buttons, notches, etc. And as you can see, there are keyboard shortcuts in the parentheses. Select the point button, and when you left mouse click on the work area, it will create a graded point. All corner points should be grade points. When digitizing, you should digitize in a clockwise direction. Instead of selecting the curve button, you can hold the shift key to create curve points as you click. If you hold the control key, it will create a graded curve point. You can see the difference. The larger square point indicates that it is a grade point. When you right mouse click, it will close the piece. After you close the piece and left mouse click again, it will start a new piece. If you make any mistakes during digitizing the pattern, you can undo by using Ctrl Z on the keyboard. After you close the piece, you can add your internals like buttons, which are drill holes, grainline, or even internal lines. Notches should be added as you're digitizing the piece. To create internal lines after you close the piece, first click on the contour button. Then digitize the internal line as you would with a regular pattern. When finished digitizing the internal line, click on the contour button again. Repeat the process to create multiple internal contours. Calibrate the image or the screen resolution. For this exercise, we will be digitizing a pattern image. And by the way, if you're using an image, you can zoom in or out by scrolling the mouse wheel. Scroll slowly or it might be a little jumpy. If you check the option, the last digitized line is the grain line, it will make the grain line parallel to the last line, which is the line that was created when you close the piece, in this case, the hem. So set the grain line if it's not the right one, and any other internal if required. You can continue to digitize another piece after closing the piece and the internals. Once done, you can click the OK button, and you can see the digitized piece or pieces in the piece bar and work area.